Hi, this is Yargamani. I am basically a management consultant and a trainer. I conduct a lot of sessions for supply chain management and logistics for industries as well as institutions. Maybe close more than 2,500 hours I would have conducted this supply chain management and logistics. Okay, so today let us go into the details of logistics. What are the components of supply chain? Plan, buy, make, move, and sell. Okay. In this, the planning phase, we have demand and supply planning, where basically we take into account what is the customer requirement, how much we have to produce for this month, produce for the day, produce for the week, and what is the overall quantity for that. So the demand is being created accordingly. They can planning can be start. And in an organization, or maybe in a factory, or maybe any sort of environment for that matter. Okay, so based on that, it is the planning is being done, and the supply planning is being carried out according to that. Just before that, so just we'll quickly see what is a how the process is there. So the process is basically how it is being done. Basically, it starts from inquiry from the customer. A different type of inquiry from the customer, and also what you can say. The thing is basically it is what you say, queries, order queries which comes from the customer. So once it is being attended to that with a due attention, and what you say, the deal is being closed. Once the deal is closed, what you say, both the parties agrees, then further the purchase order is being released by the customer to the manufacturer or the supplier, four entities. So once this conversion happens, that is the queries getting converted into an order, then there will be a very clear understanding for the sales team, marketing and sales team, and it comes percolated to the next level of planning. Further we will see what the thing. And next is sourcing and supply management. So now we are very clear about what about demand from the customer, what is the product we have to do it, and what to say, in what frequency we have to supply it, weekly, bi-weekly, or maybe monthly. So depends upon the requirement of the customer, it has been planned. And next we have raw material, correct? So the raw material has to be get into the plant or into the factory to start the manufacturing and producing the activities, correct? So that is the case. So here what it has been done is we have to sourcing is nothing but getting the material into the plant and ensure that there is a what is say there is no what is say stock out situation inside the plant, because the machines will become idle, as well as very importantly, it is to be noted that even the resource, manpower resource, also will become an ideal situation. So the sourcing department take care of this and be in touch with the supplier. Here they make a buy decision. When we make a buy, then obviously they'll be in touch with the regular supplier. And identification of the supplier is another thing that already it is being done by the sourcing department, or we can call it as commonly it is called as purchase department, where they identify this supplier what do you say, with all required infrastructure thing, then what are the technical requirements, also the financially they are how good at running the business, because here there is a risk if supplier close down their operations, and that's a big risk for the manufacturing client where metal we are buying, because when there is a stoppage of getting the material, that's a big issue. So this all being taken care, and this being done by the sourcing department, and this by the raw material from the approved sources. Then also not only the raw material, on all required parts, for example, for maintenance also some spare parts is required, and also what do you say, other assembly parts which has been to be converted into a complete product is being sourced by the sourcing team from the supplier. Next, manufacturing. Once this material arrives at it, then we know that this manufacturing activity takes place, depends upon the planning and which material, sorry, which machines this data has been loaded, and other things has been already pre-decided everything, and it goes for the manufacturing according to the schedules which is being planned. Okay. Then once the production is being started, manufacturing started, then finally the required product is being produced, and further what happens is it has to be stored in a proper storage facility. Then according to the requirement, according to the schedule of transportation, it will be transported. Why we call about storage facilities? If the product and things is being done with a due lot of care and attention, everything is being done. So when it is not being properly stored, then what happens? There is likely that it can get damaged. The products which is being produced can get a damage. Then once, when you want to ship the material to the customer, it becomes a big issue. Okay. Next, here the customer and the order is being taken into account, and according to the order requirement from the customer, the material is being the items are being packed and duly is being dispatched through the support of logistics support. So this is a manage of flow, called as manage of flow of materials, goods and service. So logistics was a supply chain. What is this? Let us see. Supply chain is not a logistics. Yes, right. Supply chain is more than logistics. Yes. Why? Because the supply chain is it's an end-to-end process. Actually, it starts from the query stage till the product is being manufactured and shipped to the end customer. So logistics is it's limited only to a particular activity of transferring the material from one place to another with a due care and support. So this covers the coordination of more active flow of, flows in the upstream from the suppliers to the manufacturing, and activities and flows from downstream from the manufacturing to the end customer. Okay. So this, what is required here? The sustainability in supply chain management is the key, because it is very important that what are the activities which is being planned that has to be happened in the regular frequency or as per plan it has to happen. Otherwise, there could be some setback in the manufacturing activity, and what will be the end of it? There could be a possible chance that this what is a metal is being planned and is being agreed to the customer the deliveries. There could be some slippages could be there. So sustainability is one of the key factor which is very important. So what it says, supply chain management encompasses of all activities associated with flow of and transmission of the goods from the raw material stage through the end user, as well as associated in the information flows. Sustainability supply chain management requires that sustainability criteria to be met while maintaining the competitiveness through the meeting the customer requirements. Why supply chains to be sustainable? As we said previously, the supply chains are boundary spanning. Why? Because coordination across the normal boundaries means that many aspects of sustainability may be affected, from initial processing of the raw material to consumption by final customer. One more thing is it reduces the cost and waste has to be taken care of, because why we talk about the reduced cost is the reduced cost is one of the key thing, because where and all possible we can minimize the cost and see that the profitability is maximized. And the second thing is waste also. Waste means some of the raw material during the processing, some raw materials that could be waste, or there could be intermittent waste could be there, or finally when the product comes out there could be some associated waste. For example, if you take injection molding. So when injection molding is there, then what happens if you want to make some cap? So the cap is being produced, but what happens? There are some few waste there. We call as runner systems in such a way that, so that is going to not add value to the product. So that has to be removed and it has to send for recycling, right? So these are different type of waste. And one more waste is very important thing is in general in an operation activity is in operations is the work which we are doing it doesn't add a creates a value for the customer or value for the money which customer pays. Any form it is called as waste. For me, unnecessary movement of the raw material, unnecessary movement of the manpower, what to say, then overproduction. So this all we call lean management, we call as a waste. So this has to be controlled and is to be sustained. So manage the risk. Risk is to be, because suddenly if there is raw material is not there, the big risk. And for the example, if you produce everything and finally when the customer comes and says that whatever you produced, there is a change in the specification or there's a change in the requirement from my end customer, please change this. So that time what happens? There's no other choice. Whatever is being produced, we have to keep it and make some alternative for that, and we should go for the fresh production and other things. And also a lot of other risks, business risks are there. Suddenly actually, see today, we have unfortunate that COVID has arisen. So if nobody has thought of it and nobody has dreamt it in our life, this would happen. So these are the things actually we talk about the risk. So which has to be taken due attention and care in the initial stages, and how it can be addressed. That is very important. So create a distinguished sellable reputation, reinforce the shareholder. It's all the important things. And thing is use of a triple bottom line, that is social thing, that is managing risk to the organization reputation, create a competitive advantage. Next is environmental, where regulatory issues are there. So regulatory issues, what we talking about here is basically it is a factory license, and a very important thing is what is pollution control norms, which we have to take care of very very promptly. We have to do that. And one more thing in this contest thing is called as consent to operate. So for example, if you are starting a new factory, or maybe in your existing facility, the existing factory, if we are going for an expansion and we have to start some with a new setup of manufacturing or production activities, definitely then it is necessary that the regulatory things calls for you go for some consent to operate once again from the pollution control board before initiating the process. So that is the way the regulatory issues, which comes very very prime requirement in today's contest. So risk of harm from usage, disposal, packaging, and shipping, because what are the materials we there doing the production or non-production areas where we have to dispose some materials after due thing, we decide that it is of no further use of that material or items. So it has to be disposed, but only one thing to be taken care is it will be properly disposed without affecting the environment. And suppose if you're just throwing the plastic items on the ground, so the soil can get contaminated, and the soil becomes infertile. This is the basic thing. And packaging thing, one thing is that when you consider about environmental things today, particularly in the logistics area where we pack the material and send it to the customer, now a lot of focus is coming on here where we have to see that we can do for recycle type of packaging. So it saves environment and it saves the cost also. So this we categorize into called as green SEM, green supply chain management, or we can say as sustainable supply chain management. Okay. And today, take it from me, the green supply chain management, or it's called sustainable supply chain management, is a very, very vital for the business today. Okay. Economic sustainability can be cost efficient. Okay. Sustainability can enhance shareholder value. This is the thing we are talking about. Sustainability supply chains, for one example at Walmart. So they follow a 7-hour principle of sustainable packaging. So just now I told that, so packaging has to be taken utmost care, because one thing is that it should be environment friendly, and it should be recyclable as possible as we can do that. It's a recycling of the packaging is a key thing, which it's a demand of the situation or need of the hour. Okay. But let us see what is 7 hours. Remove, reduce, reuse, renew, recycle, revenue, and read. These are 7 hours which sustainable packaging is being focused and planned and well executed by Walmart, for example, and they do it very efficiently and sincerely towards what is the maintaining of the environment. And many such industries, not only Walmart, many of the industries like Big Basket, for example. Big Basket is also very keen about having sustainable packaging. This sustainable packaging basically, once again, as I told earlier, it is comes in the category of green supply chain management. So be clear what is green supply chain management, because going forward in the coming days, that is going to be the prime importance of any businesses. Maybe be manufacturing, it may be supply chain, it may be logistics, any form of business for that matter. So sustainable supply chains, Walmart tells a supplier that it wants to change in packaging, that supplier will change all its packaging. Walmart has the potential to have a tremendous impact on America's environmental footprint. So these are things we can do that. Reverse supply chain, as you know, the reverse supply chain, it means enhancing the sustainability by retrieving the products from the customers, like safe and end life disposal, refurbishing, reuse of spare parts, and value recycling. It is nothing but reverse supply chain is the thing where what are the things we are supplying to the customer, and we are trying to retrieve the products from the customer. For example, I'm sending a packing material to that place, and I'm asking the people to send back that packing material back so that I can use that same packing material, I can send it back. This is one. Second thing is, there are some other items which can be just used in the reverse supply chain by retrieving the product. One classic example, you can say that in an automobile sector, for example, if you have some parts which you are buying from the supplier, maybe it may be a fuel tank, it may be some links, it may be a clamps, whatever it is. So what happens is, it can be just put it in a what is in a frame thing, and it can be just loaded in the truck, and it can be just transferred, because once the painting, for example, the painting is done and can be put it on the rack with a hook attached to that, and it can be put it in the truck and it transferred to the customer. Why? Because it is similar to that what we would have seen in cement, cement and concrete manufacturing. So what they do, they mix the cement, soil and other relevant materials, and they put it in the drum, and the drum is being switched on to the place which of origin. Then it keeps rotating at a certain RPM. Then maybe 45 minutes or 1 hour, it reaches the destination. By the time what happened, the process is getting completed, and a ready-made mixed concrete is going to be supplied to the buildings of use. Similar to that, here what is being done is the small parts, which particularly in the automobile industry, you can say, being the big companies like Ashok Leyland, TVS, TVS Motors, so they buy it from their suppliers. So what the suppliers do from their location to the their customer location, depends upon the distance of travel. So they just put it the painted parts, semi-dried, something like that, and they put it in the hook and keep it in the rack and send it by that a small truck. What happens in due course, when it is being completed in the travel mode, then with the natural air, it gets the paint gets completely dry, and it reaches the customer premises, the part is ready for fitment. So this is the case, another example we can say. So what the difference between reverse supply chain, the forward supply chain and reverse supply chain, the planning, it is a forecast in the, here, and in a reverse, it is a reactive. And location wise, one to many transportation in the forward, and reverse, many to one transportation, just opposite to that. A cost, it is forward supply chain, it is a well defined focus on the product ordering, and in the cost, it's not easily defined, and some additional requirements are there. So what are the benefits of reverse supply chain? Economic, maintain the product value, reuse and continuous improvement. Ethical, customer safety and customer satisfaction, because very important thing all of us should know, that doing business generating profit is not only the primary motive of any business requirements. The basic thing is, it should be done with all ethical means, and customer safety is very prime importance of this, and next comes only the profit. So that very important thing is the well officer should know that the business is not only for making money. Its business is all about creating a trust and value with your customer. So environmental is a product and safeguard of sustainability. Legal, it's a global rules and regulations which each all of us, it may be a general requirement or for an industry, there are set of ground rules which everybody has to adhere to that. So what are the challenges in reverse supply chain? Operational, information and process flow, so and the roles and the product. So the thing is here, what in thing information flow, that is between the supplying organization as well as their customer. So even the information is what is say, it's a lack of information is there, or lack of information is there, or properly it's not done on time, information is not given. So that time there could be all possibility there. There could be a extensive delay or some unwanted confusions created in the whole business situations. And also the process flow is very, very important in this case. Next comes financial. So here the basic thing is the cost. One area is where, suppose when you are, the thing is, for example, when I am supplying the product material or an item to the my customer, and it goes with the, some packaging, and I want to get back the packaging. Here the cost economics plays a very, very important and a vital role. So we have to be very very, very careful on this front, because see, our aim is to ensure that the environmental is not affected, but at the same time we have to keep a balance between the environment and the cost, because the cost of one thing, cost of other cannot be compromised. For example, the cost cannot be take overshoot and in the terms of maintaining the environment. So both has to be kept it balanced. That's a thing. And technological is information technology system, where it requires a lot of due things, attention and other areas. So what is the dimensions of logistics? Logistics has come long way since 1960s, and there's a big challenge to manage the whole logistics system in such a way that order fulfillment meets or exceeds the customer expectations. This is very key. Exceeds the customer expectations. Focus of this chapter is upon the individual's firm's logistics system, but also recognize that no logistics operates in a vacuum. This is a very, very important thing, because no logistics systems operates in a vacuum. It needs something. Okay. What is the contracted supply chain pipeline? It's from vendor, it goes to manufacturer, from manufacturer goes to the wholesaler, from wholesaler goes to the retailer, and finally to the customer. Okay. So this is a contemporary supply chain pipeline. Generally, many of us would have come across this, but just to for better understanding, it was we will just sort of talking about that once again. So logistics economy, because one more thing, initially I should have told this, the logistics thing, where it is it's one of the backbone of our Indian economy particularly. So generally it is 10 to 12% of the contribution comes from the logistics industry to the Indian economy. That is one. And second thing is what is the importance of logistics here is, any goods which is being produced at a particular location or particular industry of at one location, product has to be moved on to the customer end or to the market of a, maybe it may be for 10 kilometers or maybe 100 kilometers or it may be 1000 or 10,000 kilometers, whatever may be the distance, that has to be taken care. Here what is thing is be taken care is economy, because why we talk about economy? For example, instead of me sending big quantity of material, produced material, finished goods material to my customer in two trucks, can I should always see that whether I can make that two into one in one truck. So then what has to be done, the stacking methodology, or how I can place the material in the truck, and eventually. So today we have a lot of technology there. We have a CAD facilities where we can just put it in a system and see that for the size of this much of a big truck, okay, this is a space available there. So the product, the product after packaging, the primary cotton and secondary cotton, considering the outer dimensions, we can just see that how many such parts can be store there. So if you do it in a organized stacking methods, definitely we can add some 2 to 5% extra in that. Otherwise, what will happen? The 2 to 5% extra, we have to keep it away and we have to sell it in another truck, or we should see for the next truck which is go. So there is a time delay there. Also, when you go for two different trucks, then obviously there is a cost involved into that. So these are things. And some case, urgently what will happen, some metal will be required. For example, if you are sending it to a foreign customers. So if there is a scope that we can send it by sea shipment. So the thing is, only thing is, there could be a time taken to reach the destination, but the cost wise it is minimum. So what is the required thing is, accordingly, if we can produce the goods well in advance, we can make use of the sea shipment, and we can just see that we can keep the cost at the minimum requirement. So most of the time what happens in industries or in organization, it happens that we tend to miss these factors sometimes. I will not say most of the time, in sometimes we miss, and finally what happened, we have to spend very high money on sending it by air cargo. So we know that air cargo, how much cost, it is very high. It is almost 8 to 10 times higher than the sea shipment. So these are some of the planning which properly is taken care, then what happened, the cost can be kept at the minimum during these transactions and transportation of your goods. So logistics, what is logistics? Increase in recognition through the news media, corporate owned trailer promotions and televisions, increase the sensitivity to service quality provided by logistics. It is nothing but moving of finished goods to the customer, or moving of the finished goods to the market. So how we are doing, what you are doing, it's a thing. So it is having a lot of perspective, like inventory, customer, dictionary, then Society of Logistics, Council of Logistics Management, Component Support, Functional Management, and Common Culture. So continuing the, what is logistics? The popular logistics terms, logistics management, business logistics management, integrated logistics management, metals management, physical distribution management, marketing logistics, industrial logistics, and distribution. Here, what is about integrated logistics? Because here we have a lot of things like getting the material from the source, that is from the customer, and moving to one area, that may be from the central warehouse, or from the central warehouse to the customer, or intermittently we are doing a cross docking, whatever it is. So this, all these things will be properly integrated thing. Then what happens when we do an integrated way of working? So what is the thing is, the smooth flow of work will also happen in the logistics, number one. And number two, very importantly, the cost factor. Okay, because when you talk about economical thing, then the cost factor comes into picture, where we have to take the utmost care in doing this whole this activity. Okay, so next comes the material management, where the material has to be properly planned and it has to be carried out. Physical distribution management, that is, once it the consignment or the material from the area, from the manufacturing end to the nearby to the market or nearby to the customer place is reached, from there it has to be physically distributed. It is like that, for example, if you take Amazon, or if you take any first flight courier, whatever it is there. So the consignment comes to the place. For example, if we are in Chennai, okay, for example, we are in Gurgaon, or we are in Delhi, we are in Noida, whatever the area where we are. So the nearest location, and there will be an office for that particular company. So the material reaches there. From there, it has to reach the customer, right? So that is called as physical distribution management. From that place to there, we are doing it. Today, there is a lot of trials is going on in physical distribution management also, just for interest of the people. This is a case we called as innovation in logistics, because people are trying to use for small packets. It's not of weight of more than 5 kgs or 10 kgs. Okay, so they are trying to use the drone type of thing, where now the drone things were used extensively by the police department, and also in agriculture. Where they use in agriculture, they use the drone technologies by using for spraying the pesticides or something, where the human intervention could create some issues there for the people. That is the case. So distribution, as you know that, for example, if you're having a different part of the place, let us go and we have a central warehouse. From central warehouse, according to the requirement, we can just move across the system. So the 21st century of view of logistics, business logistics, it is basically a supply chain process plans that implements and controls the efficient and effective flow of goods and services and related information from the point of origin to the use of consumption in order to meet the customer requirements. Event logistics is a network activities facilities where the person required to organize and schedule and deploy the resources and event place to efficiently withdraw the event. Service logistics, it's acquisition and scheduling and management of facilities, assets, personal and materials to support and sustain a service operation or the business. What is logistics? The value added role in the logistics. What is the value? Because as we as initially I told that when we are doing some business, so there should be a value addition to the customer, because customer is paying money. We are not doing a free service in a business. Okay, so that should be a value for our money which is being paid by the customer. So that's why we are taking this part as value added role in the logistics. We'll see what is that. The most commonly referred to as terms of economic utilities is the form utility. It is what, the place utility, where, time utility, when, possession utility, why. Okay, also referred as seven RS, that is right product, right quantity, right condition, right place, right time, and right customer, and right cost. Okay, here basically it is a value adding role of logistics. What you saw fundamentally utilizing creation in the economy. What is that? Production is a form utility, the marketing it is a possession utility, and logistics is a place utility and time utility. Logistics in the firm is a micro dimension, a logistic interface with the operations and manufacturing, because it is very mandatory that this intervention, this interface is required, because it has to be interdependent. Otherwise, what will happen? What is being manufacturing? It can go wrong. And otherwise, logistics team should know what is happening in the manufacturing, because they can be assured that it will be very beneficial for their planning activities of the logistics. Because suppose if according to the schedule, if there is some delays in the schedules in the manufacturing activity, something like that. So then basically it is they can accordingly, they can plan their activities towards what you can say, how to align themselves to the manufacturing output. So that is one thing. This way, because sometime what will happen, something there could be a slight delay in manufacturing rather than what is being planned. So accordingly they can allocate the resource in some other form, and they can be utilized, the resource can be properly utilized accordingly instead of wasting the resource also. That's one important thing there. The interface is very required. Logistics interface with the marketing is very important, because the marketing is a person who is a front of the organization who works with the customer. So in case if any things there, suppose if a customer calls marketing guy, and marketing should know when the material is getting shipped, when the materials tentatively at least they will reach the destination. So logistics also should have an interface with the marketing for giving the all the right information at the right time. Logistics interface with other areas like what is supply chain and other things there, this should be taken at the utmost. So logistics interface with the operation manufacturing, it is length of the production runs, the balance economies, and the long production runs against the increased cost of high inventories, seasonal demand, acceptance of seasonal inventory to the balance and lead production times. Supply side interfaces, stocking adequate supplies to ensure that in uninterrupted production flow in the logistic functions. So or otherwise what happens if proper stocking is not being done, then there could be a set of issues that during the time. For example, let us take a very important thing is a packing material. Many time it happens that many situations, it is almost you can say a common issues across all the organization, because so generally what happens, I'll come back to you and tell you what is the reason it happens. The thing is, with a lot of struggle, the raw material will be procured, it will reach the factory, and we have a lot of challenges in the, what is maintaining your machines, machineries and equipments, because when you take for the manufacturing sometime, the machinery is breakdown, then the production will not happen. So after a lot of other challenges, when the product is being produced, and suddenly what will happen, from the stores area or from the logistics team, people will come and say, will have a thing that to the plant head or to the concerned marketing head, they say that, sir, today the material cannot be sent because there is insufficient packing materials out there. Because I will tell you why generally it happens. By if it is having effective planning, we should not definitely, there is no scope that it can happen. But sometimes what happens is it's slightly people are complacent about that. And what happens practically is we generally as a human being or professionals, we give more weightage for the procurement of the material, manufacturing of the material, maintaining the resource, maintaining the manpower, all those things we do that. And we give some least importance, I should not use word least importance, we give very less importance to the, in the for the packing materials. It's not only that, we don't want to spend more money on packing materials, because packing materials, there's no doubt that we should not use more more money there, but we should also use the sufficient money to see that the material is being being transported, is it is having it is the product is being secured. So we call it as in the right term management term is called as transport worthiness condition. So that's why actually it's very important. So many times it happens. So very important thing that when a product is taken for the production, people have to ensure that whether the sufficient packaging is there or not. If not, immediately they should ensure that it is being done within a couple of days. So protective packing, this is the thing I told. It is called as protective packing, nothing but it is called as what we can say. It is called as transport worthiness thing. So principal purpose is to protect the product from the damage. So here, with the packing, with the product inside and the packing material is being packed, and a lot of tests are there. We call it a shock and bump test, where at X and Y direction, and in some cases in Z direction also, it will be the primary cotton is being packed with the material and is being mounted on that equipment. And it is being when it is switched on, the equipment functions to and fro. That is top and bottom. That is in x axis, in the side directions, horizontally, vertically, and horizontally. Shock being produced. And one more test, generally common test which people do is called as 1 meter drop test. Is there, and another few thing is called as staircase roll down test. Staircase roll down test means, just maybe of 10-15 steps are there, we are in the top of the thing, we can just roll down the primary cotton packed with the material. So that is very important thing. We have to pack the material and we have to bring in that roll it, and we have to do it. So these are the testings which is being done because to ensure that the packaging is having the transport worthiness. That is, the principal purpose is to product not getting damaged, we are saying, right? So that is the case, because we all know that. Let us take an Indian scenario. We know about the road condition of India, and particularly if we take in rural Indias, it is much more, because roads not properly, it is having humps and dumps and a lot of damages on the road, where when the truck passes on, it's having an issue. Suppose even if we take rail transport will be not having this much of issues, but only one thing is handling. This protective packing we are talking not only in transit thing, also after the metal reaches the destination and it has to be transported to another area. So how it is being handled? You know that if you go and see in normal condition, many of the packets are being thrown from one end to another end. Even if you take an air cargo, most of the times it is not handled with due attention. But for that, what we do, we put on the top of the thing, handle with care. Sticker is being pasted. Suppose inside some material which can be tend to break. Okay, So the organization makes one what is a lot of cares in putting a sticker saying that fragile. Fragile means the metal which can bound to break. All these things due care we are taking, but still what will happen? Time and again requires a lot of efforts in making the people working in that particular environment to understand what is the thing, what is the recommend of that. That's why actually we have to have extra caution in selecting the protective packaging. Protective packaging is not only limited to your mode of transport, your what is say in transit issues. It's also when the material reaches a destination, also it's very important that how the material has to be handled. So protective packaging is a very important thing. Correct? Okay. Now coming to foreign and third party alternatives. So how we can do a logistics function of being outsourced. So here we call this 3PL and 4PL. Okay. So what is the micro dimension? The logistic interface with the marketing, and the marketing mix with 4Ps, that is price, product, and promotion. Okay, price, product, and promotion and place. These are the things. Okay, logistics in the form or the pricing. Okay, carrier pricing. So this is generally it is the larger shipment and the cheaper the transportation rate. The shipment sizes should be tailored to the carrier's vehicle capacity whereas possible. This is one. It is called as carrier pricing. Carrier pricing, but we are descending a material by truck and whatever thing is it. Matching schedules. The quantity discount should be tied to the carrier discount, quantity discounts also. Okay, so it should be linked to that. It's very important. Volume relationship. Volume sold will affect the inventory requirements. Then come to the customer packaging. Generally, size, shape, weight, and the physical characteristics of the product impact on the storage, transportation, handling, and logistics managers should be included in any decisions regarding these product traits. A minor correction in any of the above could be conceivably cost in the $1 million of logical cost. Logical costs are not necessarily the paramount, but the need to be considered in the decision-making product. Very important. Today it is, I will say today is highly important because even a rupee matters a big thing in the business. Okay, for example, if it is for a particular item, it is 1 rupee. If you are sending it 1,000 per batch, then it is almost 1,000 rupees. So every penny matters in a business. We cannot ignore it, and we should not ignore it also. The push versus pull. The most important factor is that the logistics division is aware of any change in the demand pattern so that it can plan for any consequences. So the pull strategies tend to be more erratic rather than the push strategies tend to be more predictable. So the push strategy is nothing but we know we have already what do you say a set of what do you say list where we know that which of the material is going to be forwarded which are the dates. So that is being predictable. But when you see what is different between push and pull, when I am pulling my customer or a service provider for doing an activity, then it is a pull strategy. So that is the case we have to take care. So it is very important that we have to consider whether doing a push or pull. The logistic interface with other areas, the manufacturing and marketing are probably the two most important internal and functional interface with the logistics. Correct? Everybody will agree that that actually what to say manufacturing and marketing, because marketing is a person who generates queries and converts into order and forward it to what to say planning from there further it percolates. So that's why marketing is a prime thing, and manufacturing is a person who has to convert that order into a realistic product. Okay, so our product which can be used. So these are two major functional interface with the logistics. So other important interface include the finance and accounting. Okay, it's right, because finance is one important area where how much material is being sent, how many what is say cost is being spent on each what is say consignment, all the things to be known. The logistics can have a major impact on return on assets and return on investments. So logistics costs are reported by the cost systems and supply state trade-off and performance. What are logistics activities? Let us see. One thing is the transportation. Next is storage, packaging, materials handling, order fulfillment, forecasting, production planning, purchasing, or procurement, customer service, and site location, and plus other activities. So what is the transportation role? If I'm moving the finished good product from the manufacturing site to the customer site, storage, that has to be properly stored, because here when you say non-perishable goods, perishable goods are there. The steel related parts, plastic related parts, these are things which is non-perishable goods. So it's not going to be damaged. For example, if you take a perishable goods, what are perishable goods? Particularly food products. It's perishable goods like paneer, vegetables, and other activities. So this requires a separate set of environment to do that. So we call it storage in logistics. We call it as cold storage facilities. So cold storage facilities very very much required, because the product has to be kept secured for some time. Either it being waiting for it's a waiting time for the transporting, or during the transportation also it has to be kept in the due controlled atmosphere for that condition. So it's very very important for that matter, correct? And what to say, packaging, as you know, that it should be transport worthiness and should have sufficient packing should be there. And materials handling is very important, that we have to educate the people how we have to handle the material and thing. And very important thing is today, one more thing is being missed out by me. The thing is, now the human intervention to a greater extent is being reduced in area of metal handling, because we use a lot of forklifts, we use separate metal handling equipments for that when we are going for some higher weights and things. When the human intervention comes to certain extent of small packets, something like that. And there also, if you take bigger logistics companies, they use conveyor belts. Okay, so the truck comes. So once the truck, the conveyor is being, you know, that very very classic example, you know, that is what we see in airports. Okay, the flight comes. Once the flight landed and the thing, then automatically what happens? The conveyor belts is being switched on. What I'm referring to, it's to the transport, passenger side. Similarly to in the cargo side also is being taken due and interest towards that. Toyota type of distribution moves more than 8 million parts accessories every month. Computer modeling and redesign for 30-year-old distribution network. Software looked into Lexus division, and then it is being entire network done. The new network both improved and customer services being lowered cost. The simple logistics channel, it is like this. The raw materials, raw materials and supply point is there on one side. We have it being sent to the flow is there. It is being sent to the manufacturing plant. From the manufacturing plant, it get converted into a product, or a part, and it moves to the customer market or to the customers. Okay, depends upon it's a B2B or B2C. The logistics and systems analysis, it's a cost perspective. Keep in mind that most efficient systems are not always compromised of each system component operating in the lowest possible cost. The relationship between the required inventory and order cycle length from the customer perspective. See, if you see in this particular graph, units on inventory on one side, that is on the x-axis, and the x-axis is the order cycle is there. So we can see that inventory just slide goes upon, depends upon the order cycles goes on. This is a relationship between the cost of the lost cost sales of the inventory. This is about loss of sales to the transportation cost, and this is a value to the various losses cost. Okay, thank you very much for this patient listening. So we just saw about what is logistics and other requirements here, and what is about logistics, why we need logistics, what is transporting material, and what are the packaging plays a very crucial role in the packaging and other areas. It's very important that we have to take into account of all these things together.